get that second hive today. Supposed to be a 10% chance of rain today. Right now, looking a little higher than that.
Yeah. I didn't know how you was gonna do this.
How long you been up? About 20 minutes?
Yeah,
something like that. I figure that you don't start them jobs till 6:28.
Yeah.
So I mean, this has got to be really early for you.
It is. It's, was it 3 o'clock in the afternoon?
Well, I think it was. Yeah, 3 o'clock. I know that's early for you.
Yeah, it is. That puts me way ahead of schedule.
Yeah, you could be finished and it's still gonna be light. You're not gonna know how to react.
I know. Yeah, you setting up tables and stuff. I'm not used to working with nice equipment like that.
We're going to put the coffee stand right here.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, you got to have a table. You got to have a table. That way I can lean up against it. Watch while you're working up high. I'll be down low.
That's some of that coffin wood, though, ain't it?
Yeah.
Oh,
good stuff.
Man.
Good stuff.
That's scary.
Well, look, I'm going to let you take that home with you, too.
Oh, you can have it. Let me hand you the drill. You can run on up there and do it.
Zing, zing, zing.
Are you gonna go?
Yeah, I think we could.
I don't think so. We got this diagonal brace here, and it sticks out far enough. It's gonna be hard to lean a ladder on that over there. Oh no! Look. I hope that board don't come down. I'll catch you if it does.
I hope that you get your money up front.
Yeah. Here's where they're coming in. These beams are overlapping. They're not butted up, so the bees are just walking around the end of one and back in. That's how they got to this hive. That's blocked off, kind of. There is a walk-around space, though, so. Definitely two separate hives.
Oh, man, this is a big old crack right here.
Yeah, just got the whole thing unscrewed. Can't leave him up a ladder for 2 seconds. He's gonna take everything apart. Hope the house stands when we're done.
Yeah. This is important.
You pulling nails with your teeth? What in the world, man? Look at that. I'm glad nobody stepped on that. Because I know I just sent you over there with a drill. I don't know how in the world you got that out.
Oh, wow.
See, when you're running low on pine straw, you just use nachos.
Nachos. You got any cheese in that?
Nachos and ants. No, I ate the cheese, man. I don't leave no cheese laying around. And the, what was that? Nacho bell grind. I don't know what that was.
Nacho.
A smoker.
A smoker.
Whoa,
all
that smoke.
Look at that, that's nacho smoke.
It's nacho smoke.
I can smell the salsa.
Thing is hot too. Aren't you ready to let me smoke
them
bees?
Huh?
I'm gonna smoke them bees now.
Look, buddy.
Look.
I get it.
Get it. Here, again, let me.
That's a heavy smoke.
That's the first time that smoker's ever been dropped. I can't believe you wouldn't drop that smoker like that.
And look.
You didn't see the crushed one in the bed of the truck, huh?
The what?
That crushed smoker in the bed of the truck?
No.
I grab. Look at the roaches scatter.
Ooh, roaches!
So this is how I'm setting up my frames to get ready. I've shown before, but I'll show again. I just put three rubber bands on a frame. I angle them in, because when I set the comb in, I like to be able to set it in like that and have some support. If you put them straight, then you gotta set the comb up and try to wiggle a rubber band over like that, and then they snap, or you snap bees or something. You're already working one-handed, really, because the other hand's holding the comb. So...
Get out of this video, Cole.
No, he's all right. I am. Oh, well, thank you. Thank you so much. That was very nice of you. Mr. Jeff don't get no water.
I don't deserve it. You don't give it to the person that's working.
Yeah, they didn't promise nothing to anybody that wasn't bringing them honey. Alright, I'm going in. If I'm not down in 5 minutes, call the cops.
I'm going in.
Call the fire department. So I would be up there working, but me and the boys are hanging out right now. Is that right? No, I lost it. I might have to order some more. Goodness, boy. This is a big one.
Just honey.
Solid honey. She is up close. It's a pretty hive. Nice good size hive. These are 12-inch beams. So the hive's gonna be just shy of 12 inches deep. Looks like 16-inch center. So 16 inches wide by 12 inch deep by about another 16-inch. Good size. Good healthy hive too. A lot of new comb here, new soft comb, full of honey. It's already getting on the ladder and stuff. Jeff's up here doing the hard part, taking the honey out. You get filthy taking honey out.
Ooh, woo. They didn't like that. It's gonna break in the comb, in the bucket or in my hands. It already broke. There's a bunch of brood on this one.
We gotta do the jealousy shot. The jealousy shot. one more time. Don't see her.
No.
Yeah, I hope we can find her. Everything from my neck up is solid alarm pheromones. I'm just cutting this off because you don't want to frame up honeycomb because it's too heavy and it'll just collapse on you. All you want to frame up is brood comb. I didn't get enough frames ready. I didn't think we were going to have that much brood in this one. Turned out to be a pretty decent hive. Much stronger than the last one.
When I saw your daddy use this kind of knife, made me jealous as can be. I'm telling you, this knife is, this is the ticket right here.
It works. It does work. We got more brood combs?
No, we just got it.
Laying it out, she ain't playing.
I don't know how many times I pulled her off the very last piece of comb I took out of there.
Yeah. It's like filleting a fish. Six good frames of brood comb. About a half a bucket of comb honey there. Another third, a quarter of a bucket here. Still queen hunting. Things can get a little bit messy when you're doing this. You got a storm coming, you got 5 minutes to find her. Wind's been killing us all afternoon.
You'll see that, I'm telling you, right behind that joist right there. There in there. You go up there.
She's riding on your head. Look. I come out here. I take a break, have a little water. He cuts the whole hive out while I'm gone. I mean,
yeah,
don't leave nothing.
You didn't say you went swimming in the bayou.
Don't leave nothing. Look at all the bees in there. So we're still queen, huh? Still on the queen search. I'm gonna run up here and grab her real quick, because Jeff's been up on the ladder long enough.
And I still suspect she's down there because the bees won't go behind you. They go over and then they come back, so she's not down there.
She's gotta be in that cluster. It's about couple pounds of bees over there in the corner.
There's a soft palm cluster, so.
Yeah.
And they're all on the outside of the post, too.
That's got to be where she's at.
Yeah.
We might have to just hang this box up here and let them go to it overnight.
You want to try to smoke them to make them run out?
You can.
Yeah, I think it's worth a shot.
Don't let me drop the smoker on your head.
Thank you for the warning.
Nah, they're coming out. So tell me you got her. Couldn't find the queen, so we just strapped the box to the side of the post there. Got about 1,000-1,500 bees clustered up out here, and probably triple that inside, or double that anyway. So we got all the brood in the box, taking the honey to the house, and come back tomorrow and check on this box. Like a true professional bee spotter, Jeff leaves no stone unturned, no bush unsearched.
I can't stand leaving that queen.
I know.
You know, I was up in a tree with the queen.
There's big clusters up top. What I did down here is hedge my bets. I put some queen lure on that post by the box and then dabbed some lemongrass oil on the front of the box. Not that that was necessary, but you can see it did draw a nice cluster of bees down there in the past 3, 4, 5 minutes. This over here, I tossed a couple of little chunks of junk comb over there, not thinking they would go to it, because it's a good ways from the workstation or the hive, and there's pieces of comb laying all over the ground from us cutting it out. They decided they like that over there. I don't know if it's because it's on that bush or what. As the sun sets on us again,
once more,
and I'm liking our odds, if you can see that behind us.
It looks good.
Probably, what would you say, a half hour to sunset? Half hour to sunset, the majority of the bees are starting to cluster on our box.
He put a little queen stink on that, though, so that, yeah. that was the trick. He drove them down. We tried to smoke them up there, but he put the queen's pheromone on there, and that really did bring it down.
So we're going to leave it there overnight. I'll come back in the morning and bring them back just in case. If they didn't go to the box, I'll have to back them. Hopefully they'll go to the box, and I'll close that floor back up, take them home. That'll be that. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching, Brandy, and then maybe go to mine too.
Yeah, check out the channel, Jeff Orchoff, links below.
It's Nacho Smoke.